Now I want to show you the features and functions of the Snooper Mini. The sensor cap is located at the tip of the swan neck. This can be unscrewed and underneath is the gas sensor, protected by the filter plate. The loudspeaker button and the on-off button are located under the easy-to-read illuminated LCD display. At the bottom, you will find a bar which can be used to attach hand loops, for example. The plastic housing is very robust and forgives a bump or fall. Please make sure to always switch on the Snooper Mini in fresh air. After switching on, the sensor is heated up. In the running in phase, you can see which gas the Snooper Mini is designed for. After only 20 seconds, the Snooper Mini is ready for use. Now you can see the current measured value in the upper half of the display and the corresponding unit below. Here, parts per million. The battery symbol appears after it has been determined whether the device is being operated with rechargeable batteries or with batteries. It shows the current capacity. The device will always automatically alert the user to an increased gas concentration by means of a signal tone. You can turn off the beep by pressing the loudspeaker button. The crossed out loudspeaker symbol indicates this. However, if the measured gas concentration exceeds 1 volume percent, the signal tone will automatically switch on again. If the measured value divides from 0 in clean ambient air, you can reset the zero point. To do this, press the on-off button briefly. The display shows zero. The device is ready to reset the zero point. Press the on-off button again briefly within 5 seconds. The zero point is set. To recharge the batteries of the Snooper Mini or to replace the batteries, you must unscrew the battery compartment. This is very easy to do, for example, with a coin. Remove the batteries and insert new ones with full capacity. The removed batteries can then be charged in the charging device.